The Sea King, the world's most advanced and powerful anti-submarine hunter-killer helicopter, is produced by Westland, the company with greater experience of shipborne helicopters than anyone else in the world. Operating from ship or shore, by day or night, in all weathers, the Sea King can, in addition to the anti-submarine role, meet the requirements of search and rescue, troop and cargo transport, air-to-surface strike, casualty evacuation, long-range communication, and fleet logistics generally. Its advanced automatic flight control system, search and tactical radar and navigational aids, and its integrated tactical and navigational radar display make the Sea King today's most advanced, fully automatic helicopter weapon system. It has a range in excess of 600 nautical miles, and for the ASW role, a high on-station endurance. The Sea King has ample cabin space for carrying troops, stretchers, and internal freight. Its boat hull configuration allows for emergency alighting on water. Its two Rolls-Royce Gnome H1400 gas turbines provide twin-engine safety. Operating on anti-submarine missions, the Sea King carries two pilots, an operations officer, and a sonar operator. Full dual control is provided for the pilots. Approaching an ASW search area, the pilot operates the controls to set up an automatic transition down to the hover at a predetermined height for sonar search. Automatically, height and forward speed are reduced until, without any effort on the part of the crew, the helicopter comes to the hover at the predetermined height for sonar dunking. The fully automatic system ensures that transitions to the hover can be achieved safely and accurately in bad weather, in poor visibility, and at night. After the sonar transducer is lowered and submerged, the automatic system ensures that correct height is maintained and that drift is eliminated, so that the signals fed from the sonar transducer provide accurate target information. Underwater target contact results in a bright spot on each of the sonar screens. The screen on the right is a Doppler display indicating relative movement of the submerged target. The screen on the left is a sector display showing the bearing of the target. Range scale is located between the two screens. The sonar information is fed across to the radar display, which, when using planned position indication, or PPI, shows the search helicopter's position in the center of the plot. The broken line indicates the helicopter's heading. Transponder identification in the form of short arcs show the position of supporting helicopters. As the sonar operator tracks the submarine, the operations officer has a continually updated indication of the target position. The continuous line shows the bearing of the target. As an alternative to PPI, the tactical plot is frequently used in the ground stabilized mode. Range indication can be selected for scales ranging between a half and 10 nautical miles to the inch. The tactical plot can be switched from one form of indication to the other, information being updated and stored automatically. At the end of the search, or when it is necessary to move to another search area, the sonar transducer is raised and the pilot sets the automatic controls so that the helicopter automatically increases speed and climbs away from the hover to a predetermined height and heading. Backed by thousands of hours of test flying and based on a well-proven airframe, the Sea King benefits from the development and service experience gained with the similar advanced ASW system used in its predecessor, the Westland Wessex 3. A further advance of great benefit in shipborne operation is the speed and simplicity with which the main rotor blades and the tail can be folded to facilitate hangar stowage. Blade folding is achieved automatically by the pilot from the cockpit. The tail locking mechanism is released by the operation of a simple ratchet lever. The tail can then be folded manually as a simple operation to reduce considerably the length of the stowage area. This is another example of close attention to shipborne requirements and results in a wide range of ships being capable of accepting this moderately large helicopter and reduces the shipboard hangar space to reasonable dimensions. Particularly suited to the SAR role by virtue of its advanced equipment, rescues can be effected by the Sea King operating from ship or from the shore. In shore-based operations, the helicopter's range and speed show to advantage. Numerous deck operations were carried out from the Royal Navy support ship, the RFA Engadine, as part of the intensive flying trials carried out during No. 700S Squadron's 2,500 hours intensive flying program. A large number of Sea King helicopters have been ordered by the Royal Navy. Considerable interest has also been shown by overseas navies, and export orders have already been received both for the anti-submarine and search and rescue versions of this advanced helicopter. In quantity production at Yeovil, the Westland Sea King is in squadron service with the Royal Navy, where the helicopter's performance and capabilities, resulting from the advanced flight control, navigation and search systems applied by Westlands, have created a very favourable impression. In the troop transport role, the Sea King can carry 24 troops in seats aligned around the cabin periphery. In the medical or casualty evacuation role, stretchers can be fitted in tiered rows along the length of the cabin. In the anti-submarine configuration, the cabin contains the sonar transducer, cable and winch control, together with the radar and sonar displays, at the positions of the operations officer and sonar operator. In the SAR roles, the cabin contains the radar display, the remainder of the cabin space being taken up with either troop-type seats or stretchers or a combination of each. Capable of operating by day or by night, in all weathers, and fitted with the most advanced equipment, the Westland Sea King is today's most outstanding contribution to naval helicopter operations, shipborne or land-based.